We'll start the session now. Who is this? Mahesh. Mahesh, you don't have a... Let me check. Yeah. Mahesh, you can record the session. Okay. Afifa joined from phone today. A tab.
Yes. With phone.
Okay. That's fine. Okay. Right. Okay. That's fine. Let me share my screen. Okay. So anyone completed the assignment? Yesterday we have discussed, right? Creating tables, databases and all.
Yes, sir.
So everything is okay?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, did you face any challenges in creating the tables and all?
No, sir.
Okay, great. Okay. So, right, in case if you don't create the tables or databases, either just at least today also you just create, okay? Don't skip the practice. It is very important. Try to create the tables and databases today. And that is also important. Of course, in the organization, we usually don't create the table, but sometimes if anyone asked you to create the tables and all, they will provide you the scripts. Okay. Sometimes they will ask us to create the table. Say, please create the table. If they gave the script, that's fine. You have to simply execute that script. If they didn't give the script, ask them, please provide the script. Okay. So that we can proceed for this. Okay. Activity like that. You have to send an email. Okay. So who is this? Yes. Yeah, sir. Thank you for that. Okay. So, right. So in case if anyone wants to take the script, you can check in the chat. Okay. Srinivasra posted the script for creating the tables, I guess. Databases also. Okay. So you can copy the script and you can execute, but try from your side also. Try to create manually. Okay. Right. So in case if you want to create the table using GUI option, we can still create the table using GUI option also. Yesterday we discussed how to create the tables using query method. Okay. If you want to create using GUI, go to any database. On which database you want to create a table. Okay. Right click, new table. Okay. So column name, imagine I want to create a colors table. Okay. Color ID, data type, integer. You have to select from this drop down. Okay. You can choose from this drop down. See, these are all our data types only. Okay. See how many data types are there. Begint, binary, bit, char, date, time, offset, decimal, float, geography, geometry. Like we have a lot of int, money, and char, and text, numeric, and var, char, max, and char. Small int. So a lot of data types are there. Okay. So we are going to use only few of the data types. Developers and all going to use other data types as well. Okay. So this is my color ID one column, and it should be integer. Okay. And color name. Okay. You can give as var char. Var char of 100 is fine. Okay. Let me type var char of 100. Okay. So like this, if you want to create the table, so these are the column names. How many columns you want to give? Simply you have to type the column names. Okay. So I just gave two columns. In case you want, you can give extra columns also, like cost and all, color cost. Okay. So I can type as money, right? So like this, if you want extra columns, you can simply specify the columns and all. Okay. Right. So just click on the save button. It will ask you the table name, colors. Okay. Just click OK. Automatically table will be created. Okay. So if you see here, you can see extra table called colors. Where is that? Let me close it. Yeah, you can see this colors table. Okay. So this is how we can create the tables using GUI option. Okay. But no one will prefer creating tables using GUI. Everyone will go with the query method only. Okay. So usually we don't create the tables. Even developers also don't create the tables using GUI method. So just for basic idea, how to create the tables using GUI and all. So you can use this method. Okay. So again, inserting tables using GUI is very difficult thing. Again, you have to insert. Okay, each and every column, or else each and every particular row is there, right? You have to insert those rows and all. It will be difficult. So usually developers will prefer script only. Okay, they are going to prefer script only to create or to insert the values inside the table. Right, clear, right? So fine, let me create an employee table, or else we have, how many tables we have here? Student table, right? So let me go with the student table. So how can I read the table? I want to read the table. I want to see how many records are there in the table. How can I do that? What is the query? I want to see all the records of the student table. What is the query? Select star from student. Okay. So if you run this one, you can get the output, right? So let me run it. What error I am getting?
There is a master menu. I told you, sir. Database menu.
Okay, very good. Okay. So we have to consider again and again. Okay. We have, let me give you the recording permissions. Deva, you have joined from laptop. Yeah. Okay. You can record the session, Deva. Fine. Okay. So again, I'm saying whenever you're running any query, you have to check the database name here. Actually, my table is created in the Bash 39, but you are searching in the master database. How come it is possible? Created table in one database, searching the table in another database. Is it possible? Can we pull the data like that? So it's not possible. So you have to change the database here before running any query. You have to check on which database I'm running this query. This is very important thing. So for every query, by default, check on which database you are running. So any other way without changing the database name here, by just modifying the script, can we execute this query? Do we have any other way to run this query without changing the database name here?
Yes, we have
use database name. Very good. Other than that, without using that use database name query, do we have any other way? So actually the table full name, you know, what is the name of the full name of the table? Okay. Database name dot schema name dot table name. Okay. Right. So you can replace now. Okay. What is the database name? Bash 39. Dot dbo dot student. Okay, so in this way also you can give, right? Sometimes developers will write queries like this also. Don't worry. Okay, this is the complete format of the table, full name of the table. Okay, either you can give just student, but you have to choose the database here. Okay, or else you can give just student, but before to this line you have to, okay, use this query, use database name, use bash 39. Okay, or else without changing these two, without giving bash 39, without changing the database name here, you can directly, okay, run this query. This is the complete name of the table, database name dot schema name dot table name. Sometimes you can see like this also, instead of schema name they will just keep two dots. Means by default it will take schema name only. If you want to see, you can see it, dbo. Okay, let me run with the dbo first. I'm not changing the database. I'm not using this query also. You can still pull the data. Okay, so what is the full name of the table? Database name dot schema name dot table name. Or else if the table is created in the DBO schema, okay, you can simply give like this also, two dots. Okay, two dots also you can give, and then also you can pull the data. No need to change the database here. No need to run this query also. Again, some developers will write the script like this. So you have to understand, at least, see, usually in the organization, no one will ask us to write the scripts and all. It's a developer's work. DBA usually is going to maintain the databases, is going to take care of the databases. So we usually don't write lines and lines of coding. For DBA's coding won't be there. Okay, just for developers, coding part and all, logical part and all can be handled by the developers, development team. Okay, so at least you are in a position, okay, to understand the scripts at least. you should be in a position to understand each line. Sometimes if you see any query like this, don't worry, simply he is pulling the data from a table. Okay, so this is the format: database name dot schema name dot table name, or else database name dot dot student table name. Means simply dot dot means by default it will take DBO schema. If it is in different schema, you cannot pull like this. If it is in DBO schema, by default most of the tables will be created in DBO schema only. So then you can simply mention dot dot here. Okay, clear? Any issues? Any doubts? Just 1 minute, guys. Right, okay, that's fine. Okay, so is it clear, guys? Any issues, any doubts? Okay, so you can mention the table name like this also, with full table name. Okay, database name dot schema name dot right table name, right? So let's go with the filtering of the data. Okay, so we'll filter the data now. We'll search the data. We are going to use where condition or where class. Using where class, you can filter the data. See, for example, you are doing online shopping, right? So sometimes imagine you are doing shopping in Ajio or else like Myntra. Okay, these two are like you can buy clothes and all, right? So usually while doing shopping, okay, you are going to set filters, right? Right. So filters, you will choose filters. Why? Because lot of clothes will be there and with different sizes and also what we'll do to just complete the order quickly, we are going to search with the filters. We'll apply the filters. So what kind of filters we are going to apply? Size, cost, rating. Okay, so we are going to select these filters, right? So once you just select that filters, what will happen automatically? Say, for example, you want to see the reviews more than 4. So if you go to the filters, if you select the reviews greater than or fold, greater than or equal to 4, then automatically you can see all the products that are there with the reviews more than 4, right? Fine, so it is easy. Yeah.
This is Srinath, sir. Please give me the recording permission.
Yes, Srinath. Let me see. Yeah, you can record.
Okay, sir.
So, yeah, it is easy to filter the clothes and all. Okay, it will be easy. So, we can complete the. Yeah. That's okay. Who is this? Okay. Right. So it is easy to filter the objects and all using filter option. Okay, in the same way, I want to filter the records from this table. I want to filter whose name is Ramu. I want to filter whose student number is 1, whatever it is, 1 or 2 or 3. I want to filter who are studying in the class 8. I want to filter only student names from this table. I want to filter only class column from this table. How can I do that? Okay, so let's do that. Say, for example, if you give select star from table name, then you can see star means what? Star means what?
All columns.
Yes, all columns, not all records. Of course, if you refer all columns, if you select all columns now, automatically all records are selecting, right? Just a minute.
Yeah.
Okay, so see, for example, if you are pulling, let me go with this one, student number, student name, class. So if you are selecting all columns, means you are getting all the records, right? So star means all the columns. Okay, star means all the columns. Once you are pulling all the columns, of course you are going to get all the records, right? I just want to pull only student number column. How can I pull that one? In this table, I just want to pull only one column.
In query, we want to write the class, select Ash from class.
I just want to pull student number column.
Where student number is equal to one.
No. Then you will get only Ramu record. Okay.
Okay.
Yeah, I don't want to pull this one. I don't want to pull this record. I just want to pull this highlighted column. Okay. Just want to pull S number, student number. How can I do that?
Select this name.
That's it. Okay. So you have to mention number. The column name. That's it. Very good. You have to mention the field number. Vertical entity is called field or column. Horizontal entity is called row or record. Okay. Which column you want to pull? Select that column only. Star means what? All columns. I don't want all columns. I want only one column. Give only one column. Select test number from table name. Okay. So if you run, you can only pull student number. See here. Just filtering. It's just filtering. It's not deleting. Okay. It's just filtering from three columns. It is just pulling one column that we have mentioned. Now I want to pull S number and S name. How can I do that? Two columns I want to pull now.
Easier to mention the two field numbers, sir. Two field numbers or two name of fields.
That's it. Okay. So you can mention here. So if you want to pull the S name also, right? S number, S name. How many columns you want? 100 columns are there. Imagine in the table, 100 columns are there. You want to pull 10 columns only. You have to mention the column names in the select query. Okay. You have to mention the column names in the select query so that only you can pull only those columns. Okay. Now I'll pull S number and S name. And you can see, if you run this query, you can see only two columns. This is called filtering the data. Okay. Whatever columns you want, you can pull those columns only. Whatever records you want, you can pull those records only. Right. So this is how we can pull the columns. If you want only columns, a specific column, mention the specific column in the table name, select query instead of star. Star means it will pull all the columns information. Okay, if you need any specific columns, mention that column name in the select query. Select column name from table name. This is the query. Okay, right, fine. So now I want to pull those who are studying class 8. Yes, tell me.
In our table, we have 15 fields.
Yes.
But we have to see only four of fields. How to write the query, sir?
Yeah, tell me. You only tell me how to write the query in 15 fields. You want to pull four fields.
But I want the field number 1 and field number 5 and field number 7 only. But we have 15 numbers of fields.
Why you want like that? First of all, tell me.
Sir, in 15 number fields, in table 15 number, have 15 number fields. That's a big table, sir.
That's what. See, if it is a big table, small table, you are asking column number 1, column number 3, like that, right? Whatever columns you want, you can mention the column names.
That's it.
Okay. So if you want, see here, control Z, let me go with this one. So for example, here, I want to pull S number. Okay, if you go with the complete select query, you will get three columns, S number, S name, class. If I want to pull only S number and class, not S name, I want to pull S number and class, this column this column.
S number and S class.
That's it. Whatever columns you want, you can mention. Yeah, S number, comma.
S number and comma, class.
That's it. From table name. You can pull like this. Whatever you want, see, if you want 1, 3, 5 columns, if you want one direct 14th column, whatever you want, you can simply mention the column names here. Okay, fine,
okay.
Right.
Okay, sir.
So I want to pull the data. I want to filter the data. Whose name is Ramu? I want to filter the data. Who are studying in class 8? So how can I do that?
In a where condition.
Where condition. So you have to apply where condition or where class. Okay, where class, C-L-U-A-S-E, not C-L-A-S-S. Okay, where class you have to apply. So you have to give where class here. Okay, if you want to pull specific records. Okay, if you want to pull specific records, then you can apply where class. Okay, so let me apply the where class. Okay, can anyone tell me a query? I want to pull a record. Whose name is Ramu?
Select
star from table name.
Where S
number
is equal to 1.
Where S number? Why you are always concentrating on S number? Okay, so just try to filter with the proper parameter. Okay, if you give you one also, it will pull the Ramu record. But do you know Ramu S number is 1? Now you are seeing the table, that's why you are asking where S number is equal to 1. Okay, but usually if you don't see the table, how come you know Ramu student number is 1? Right? Fine, right? So whatever property we are going to search it, try to search with the same parameter. I want to pull how many Ramus are there in our class. So what I can do, select star from batch or else complete table name, where condition you have to use where. S name is equal to Ramu. Okay, fine. So now if you run this query, you can get only Ramu's record. Now I want to see how many are there with the Damu. What I have to do?
Name I want plus to write Damu.
Yes, okay. So simply let me replace this R with D. Now if you run this query, you can see there are 2 Damus are there in our class, in the student table. Okay, so simply if you want to pull specific records, you have to use this where condition or where class. If you want to pull specific columns, you have to mention column names in the select query. Right, now tell me, I want to pull those who are studying in class 8. I want to pull all the students studying class 8.
Where class is equal to 8.
That's it. Select star from table name where class is equal to
8.
That's it. I want to pull whose student number is 9. I want to pull the student
S number is
yes.
S number is equal to 9.
Very good. Now you came to know the test number. Okay, you want to use the test number at anyhow. Where S number is equal to 9. Okay, so if you give like this, there are 2 students. Okay, there are no students with S number 9. Okay, let me check. Yeah, there are no students with S number 9. Okay, you can see here up to 7 or up to 6 only we have students. Okay. So that's why we don't get any records. Imagine if you want to get with the number 6. Who is the roll number 6? Just replace number 9 with number 6. And if you run it, you can see number 6 student is Samba. Right? So this is how you can pull the records using where condition. Okay? Where condition will help you to... Nothing is there. Simply whatever you want, mention that property. That's it. Mention the column name properly and give the value. That's it. Automatically you can get it. Remaining select query is same to same. How you can run select star from table name, this is same. This is not going to change. Simply add where condition here and give the parameter. Which parameter, with which parameter you are searching? Student number, student name, okay, a student ID, right? So let me check any other tables we have. Okay, we don't have other tables. Okay, so this is how you can pull the data and this is how you can filter the data using specific column names and using where condition. Okay, so now can anyone tell me what is the where condition? Okay, what is the query to pull employee name as Srinivas.
Just to select.
Table name is employee table, and I want to pull how many Srinivas are there in my employee table.
Yeah. Now tell me. Where column name equals to Srinivas, sir.
Are you sure?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Select star there, from yeah.
There e name is equal to Srinivas.
Yeah, that's fine. Yeah. E name, employee name, that's fine. Okay, so select star from employee. Table name is employee, right? Select star from employee. Okay, where e name or employee name, anything e name. You can give. Okay,
employee where e name, name is equal to?
Yeah, Srinivas, whatever Srinivas. Name. So as it is string, you have to keep it in a single. That's why if you see here, for number, I didn't keep it in a single quotes. For name, I just kept it in a single quotes. Why? Because for characters, you have to give this. Okay, string values. Okay, this is called string. For string, you have to give this single quotes. Okay, for numbers and all, no need to give any single quotes. For string values, you have to give this single quotes. Okay, then only it will search exactly. Yesterday I told you, right? Imagine, okay, Srinivas Verma is there. Okay, they are going to enter the record like this, Srinivas Verma. If you don't provide, Srinivas will be treated as one name, Verma will be treated as one name, and it will throw the error. So that's why just keep it. Okay, if you want to read the whole Srinivas Verma as a one word, we have to keep it in a single quotes. Database name is required, Ramesh. Okay, here you have to give database name. I didn't mention the database name. Okay, you have to give database name. In case if you don't want to give database name here, select the database name from this drop down. Okay, fine. So this is how we are going to filter the data, right? Clear, right? So tomorrow's assignment, create employee table with e number, e name, salary, and location. Okay, right? And I need all the employees who are working from Hyderabad location. I need all the employees. Okay, try to insert some records from the Hyderabad or your own location. See, don't mind, guys. Don't keep it as a Hyderabad, your own location. Just want to check whether you are aware of this air condition or not. Just only for that purpose only. If you want to keep Bangalore, if you want to keep Delhi, if you want to keep Singapore, whatever you want, you can keep it. Okay, so just want to check whether you can write air conditions or not. I need all the employees, okay, who are drawing salary more than 50,000. Who are drawing salary more than 50,000, okay, 50K, right? And I need all the employees information, okay, whose name is, some XYZ, okay, keep it your own name, XYZ, right? You can choose name, okay? So that's it, okay? So just try to create an employee table. And just, I need a script for all these three things. I need script for employee table, creating employee table with these four columns. And I need script for these wear conditions also, for these requirements also. I need script, okay? Tomorrow, not tomorrow, we are going to meet on next Monday, right? So please complete this assignment, okay? I'll ask everyone, please send me the script, okay? To my WhatsApp, I'll check. In case if you don't send, I'll ask you in the class. Okay, clear, guys? Right, fine, good. Okay, so that's it. Okay, so let's discuss about another topic. So that's it from table sets. And the remaining and all, we don't discuss, we don't want to use, okay? This completely development part is going to be taken care by the developers, so nothing to use. This is just basic knowledge that is fine for us, okay? You just keep learning if you are interested. See, if you are good in T-SQL, this is all T-SQL. Whatever scripts, whatever queries we ran, those scripts are in T-SQL, Transact SQL. If you are interested on coding, you can go and learn, okay, T-SQL and all. But for DBA, this is fine. We usually going to use where conditions. We usually going to pull some columns. Okay, this is fine for us, right? So the next topic is patching. Okay, so let me close this meeting. It is going to close now. It is showing 3 minutes. We'll start fresh. Okay, concept with the new recordings. Let me close this meeting. Let me reopen the meeting again. Okay, we'll discuss patching. Okay, let me close it and let me reopen. Please join immediately.